Welcome friends, welcome back to the kitchen. Today we're going to do a recipe that first appeared on the channel 10 years ago. And I was looking for a recipe, what to cook for dinner tonight, and I thought I'd just take a look back through the old recipes on the channel and see which ones we still make and which one I would be inspired by for tonight. And I came across this recipe and I thought, oh, I should make that. It's essentially just beans and tomatoes with chicken on top. And then I read the recipe and I realized that even though I thought that, you know, I'm continuing to make exactly the same thing as that recipe, over time it's shifted, it's changed. My memory of what I think I'm making and what I'm actually making are two different things. And I know that that happens with a lot of recipes. And I know that happens to a lot of people. They think they're making the same thing over and over, but over time, differences creep in, little changes are made, you make a substitution one night and you realize you really like that, so you keep doing it that way and you forget that you made those changes. So I'm going to do the recipe over. Now, the first change, or the biggest change I think, is that in previous versions I didn't brown the chicken first. I put the chicken on top, baked it, and broiled it to get the browning action. And somewhere along the line, I started putting the chicken thighs into the pan and doing it in a cast iron pan like this brazier instead of doing it in a glass dish. So if you go back, I'll try to link to that recipe down below. Go back and look at it and kind of see how this recipe and method has morphed over time. So I'm not seasoning the chicken thighs at all. There will be a lot of seasoning put on these later, so it doesn't need it right up front. And I'm just going to brown them on both sides, get a little bit of color and build some fond in the bottom of the pan. Okay, while that's happening, I've got a mortar and pestle here and some spices. So first in, I'm gonna put some salt and some black pepper, really easy to taste. I've got some oregano, some red pepper flakes, and a little bit of fennel. And I'm just going to crush these together a little bit. Break up the fennel and the hot pepper. Okay, these are looking good. I don't need to introduce too much browning on them because I'm still gonna put them on top of the dish, stick it in the oven, and get them browned that way. I just wanna build a little bit of flavor in the bottom of the pan. So I'm gonna pull these out for now and set them aside. And into the pan, maybe turn the heat down just a touch, I've got some tomato paste. And I'm gonna put about half a can of tomato paste in there. And I'm gonna fry that tomato paste in the fat from the chicken and the grease and the browning. And I wanna reduce the tomato paste a little bit and I want to caramelize all of the sugars and really bring out that flavor. Now, I've got some garlic cloves and I'm just going to crush those in. So I've got that tomato paste really nice and caramelized. It brings a really great flavor when you do this because it's not going to bake in the oven for a really long time. For a lot of stews where it's going to cook a long time, I don't take this step with the tomato paste all that far or as far as this. But because this is only going in the oven for a short amount of time, I'm going to do that in the pan. So this is anchovy paste. It's something that if I have it, I'll put it in, and if I don't have it, I won't put it in. And if you've got whole anchovies in a little jar, two or maybe three of those anchovies would be good. And so we'll get those in the pan, we'll stir them in with tomatoes. I'm on sort of medium-low heat at this point. Bring those all together. And now I'm going to put in a cup of wine, maybe a little bit more than a cup of wine. And I'll turn the temperature on the stove up. And I will boil off most of that wine. I'll reduce it down by at least 2/3. So I'm going to go back up to sort of a medium-high temperature at this point. Now, as this reduces down, I'm going to take about a third of the spices that I've got in here in the mortar and pestle, and I'm going to put them into the pan and just mix them in. The rest I'm going to hang on to for later. And that's looking really good. So, now it's just an assembly. I've got a can of whole tomatoes, and I have just taken a knife and run it through the can to break them up a little bit. If I had diced tomatoes or crushed tomatoes, I would have used those in its place. I've got two cans of beans, and one is black-eyed peas and one is navy beans. If you know from other videos, I really like to mix up the beans. You could use cannellini or white kidney beans. Those would work really well. For green, I have some broccoli and the stems. I've cut up the entire head of broccoli, stems and all. And so I'm just going to stir this together. I've got broccoli, but it could easily be broccoli rabe. It could be kale. It could be spinach. It could be Swiss chard. I put that in when Swiss chard is in season in our garden. Just something green to give a little bit of vibrancy and change the color a little bit. It could also be peas or anything. I mean, if you like a different kind of vegetable, you could throw it in there just to give a little bit of a different texture and a little bit of different flavor. So I'm going to put the chicken back on top, and I'm not going to bury it. I'm just going to leave it on top of the other mixture. And then I'm going to take spice that's left in the mortar and pestle and just sprinkle it on top of the chicken, on top of the rest of the dish, just to get it everywhere. Now, I've got the oven preheated to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. I would normally cook it a little bit hotter for a shorter amount of time, but I'm a little early today on my timing, so I'm going to cook it at a lower temperature, and then I'll bump the temperature just as Julie comes in the door from work to crisp up the top. Okay, so here we go. Scoop some chicken.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. That looks familiar. Yeah. Like, that's a dish we eat often.
It is a dish we eat often. It is. I really like it. I think that it's, you know, it's that combination of a bean stew with some chicken on it.
And it has so many variations. Like, yeah, as long as you put that fennel in, yeah, it's good to go. Yeah. Beans, whatever you got, vegetables. Well, I mean, the tomatoes are important too.
Well, today we did broccoli.
I can't even get any up. There we go. Mm-hmm.
That bean and tomato stew. Mm-hmm. Absolutely great. Chicken, crispy skin on the outside. Hit a heat.
What did you add to it?
I added maybe a little bit more red pepper flake than I normally would.
Okay.
And for everyone who's freaking out about the anchovy paste, don't.
There you go. Don't.
That's really good. Chicken is really good. Thighs in this are really good. Don't freak out about the anchovy paste, because the anchovy paste, you're not going to taste it. It does a lot of what I usually lean on Marmite for, right? It brings a big umami flavor, and it draws out some of the flavors of the tomatoes. So don't worry about the anchovy paste. It smells horrible when you're putting it in. I'm with you on that. I don't like the smell when I put it in, but once it's cooked in there, it's great.
And you know what's funny is we have a bunch of spinach in the fridge that you could just throw on there and steam it on in the last minute.
Yeah. That's it. That's it. Spinach would go great in that.
Yeah. Last few minutes. Yeah. Be really good.
So this is an easy weeknight meal. It doesn't take that long to pull it together, throw it in the oven, do a bunch of stuff for like a half an hour while the chicken cooks, and supper's on the table.
Ta-da!
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.